Pittsburgh.
26 goals. Halfway through the season, no one in the Eastern Conference has more, and only one more in the NHL, Tyler Seguin of Dallas with 27. Sidney Crosby, captain of the Black and Gold Penguins, on one of his hottest runs of the year. A dozen points in the last half dozen games. Nash's line starts. Crosby's line waits. Paul Martin, Chris Letang will anchor the defense for the Penguins at the beginning. Nick Spaulding, Brandon Sutter, and Steve Downey across the front line. Derek Brassard, Matt Zuccarello, and Nash. Mark Stahl and Dan Boyle, the defense for the Rangers. Zuccarello with the first puck to play. Off Letang, ricocheted off Sutter, played across to Downey. Downey flipped one that skittered off the corner shelf and is played by Lundqvist. In some traffic, dug out by Sutter, angled back, but through Letang, might be a chance here. Racing up the wing is Nash. Nash with a shot, he scores! Nash at 26 seconds.
Well, Brandon Sutter tries to get this puck to Chris Letang. If he gets this puck, he's got something going. But Rick Nash picks up this puck. Quick wrist shot, short side on Marc-Andre Fleury for goal number 27.
It's a little bit of bad luck, as Eddie was just saying, for Letang, but watch how Rick Nash will just blow that short side by Marc-Andre Fleury. Eddie, you gotta wonder if he's not playing the pass a little bit too much there, talking about Marc-Andre Fleury.
Downey tips it on to him once more. Letang able to emerge and get it back to Sutter. Across now to Malkin. Malkin holds, shoots one, and it went just wide of the long side. Kept alive, back over for Malkin yet again. Fed one in front, dished off! Oh, it wouldn't go for Sutter as Lundqvist was there.
Beautiful play from Downey.
Letang across, Malkin a shot, save Lundqvist, swatted away by the defense, battled for and cleared as far as center.
To go to the net like that, outstanding.
Line and drive, oh, and a sizzler that popped off the net and right in front, and a shot, score! Brassard was the man out in front as the puck ricocheted back out into the slot, and the Rangers have a 2-0 lead.
Well, one of the first rules when you're taking a faceoff in your own zone, don't lose a draw clean. Derek Brassard, he gets a scramble draw and a little bit of help from Rick Nash, and then just pile drive the puck on goal, goes up high. Derek Brassard wheels and blasts it by Marc-Andre Fleury. But it was the support from Rick Nash on the faceoff. Crosby did his job scrambling the draw, and then Eddie, what a finish by Brassard.
Well, the crazy carom off the shot from Klein. Nobody really knew where that puck was, and it just found its way right back to the front of the net. Brassard took a big hit from Kunitz as he let it go, but no chance there for Marc-Andre Fleury. So a fortunate bounce, and the Rangers with an early 2-0 lead.
The extra man is Crosby. Turned back along for a shot pass by Erhoff to Crosby. Popped up in the air. Spotted away by Girardi as it was coming down, a hooking call.
Crosby had a chance to put the puck into the wide open net as it moved right to left on Henrik Lundqvist. Wasn't able to cash in, but the second power play coming for the Penguins is Marty St. Louis is going to get caught for a hook.
Crosby around behind the net. Letang has gotten to the point now. Shoveled one that came back to him from Malkin. Then on over for Peronza.
There's Crosby, and the Penguins are going to be able to move this puck from defenseman to Perron. And the wide open net for Crosby.
And Eddie, he's looking past all the way to Sidney Crosby's stick, which is presented behind Ryan McDonough. So it's a great job by Letang and Perron moving the puck up high and finding the wide open Crosby in the back door.
But that's why a system's in place. That's where everybody knows where they're supposed to be in case there's a breakdown.
Score! Nash backed off, flipped one, deflected in, and it's 3-1 in favor of the Rangers.
This goal has all kinds of odor on it for Marc-Andre Fleury, Eddie.
Yeah, this puck goes in off the stick of Rob Scuderi. Face-off win. A lot of time. Just fire it towards the net, and there's Rob Scuderi. No chance for Marc-Andre Fleury. He's anticipating this puck coming right into the midsection. And then there you see the stick of Scuderi deflecting that puck up and over his goaltender.
Derek Brassard with another faceoff win, beating Brandon Sutter. And that's the odorous part. Scuderi gets it up and over, and there's not much Fleury can do on it.
Kreider to play it around behind and scale it back up to San Luis. San Luis has a man right in front of him there, and it is thrown into the net. What a shot. Stepan let it go, and it is 4-1 Rangers.
Eddie, he never seizes because of Chris Kreider. The guys were talking about Kunitz and the job he does for the Penguins. What a job by Chris Kreider. Excellent puck movement by the Rangers, including Marty St. Louis right here. Watch 20. He'll go with the track of the puck. He's right in front. Look at Fleury trying to see through the wall that Chris Kreider is.
Short side, but this all started because of the breakout by the New York Rangers. Look at the Pittsburgh Penguins. They're all standing still. Here comes Brassard. He's able to enter the zone, and then eventually, 20 seconds later or so, the Rangers are able to put the puck into the back of the net. Going to have a goaltending change. Short side shot there from Derek Stepan, who comes off a two-assist game in the Rangers' last game in a win over the Columbus Blue Jackets.
And a change, and so as a result, having to hurry to get back is DeBray. There is a call that is delayed. Onto the back, Girardi poked it on across. McDonough let it back on for the play to be made by Hayes.
That last rush for the Penguins, you had Letanga defenseman Dupre that were up on the rush trying to generate and create something.
Perron brings it on, is able to get right in. Oh!
David Perron's able to go right through Dan Girardi and Ryan McDonough. Nice play there from Bortuzzo to get the puck up to David Perron, and the puck finds its way right between the legs of Henrik Lundqvist.
Go back to the first period when I talked to Mike Johnson. He said we need slash skating through the inside part of the ice. That's an example of a slash skate by David Perron through the defenseman Girardi and McDonough coming through the inside seam.
Back up with it now is Malkin. Spiked away by Stepan, and he will come back. As a couple of wingers, San Luis Chamberlain in front. Stepan a shot. He scores! It is 5-2.
Turnover in the middle of the ice by Evgeny Malkin. Derek Stepan's able to jump on this puck, and it looks like the Rangers have a 3-on-2 coming. Stepan to St. Louis, he gets hit by Malkin, and then the deflection goes right back to Derek Stepan, and the Rangers with a huge goal make it a 5-2 game.
What a finish for Derek Stepan, whose old coach at Shattuck St. Mary's, Tom Ward, texted us this morning to wonder how Derek was playing, whether he's gonna have a big game. I said, I don't know, but I think he'll probably have a big game, pretty well coached.
Twisted it on back, but that ricocheted across, and here's Perron. He's got Crosby breaking up the wing. Perron looking, shooting, oh! We'll slow it down for you. That's a strong shot. Lightning-like save, 5-2 Rangers. To the Islanders in Pittsburgh. And so they make it a tighter race. It will be 5 points separating first through fifth. Fourth place, I beg your pardon, 56-61. We'll be back with a wrap up here from Pittsburgh. Final score in the game, Rangers 5, Penguins 2.